Many cultures have stories about a mythical potion that will grant eternal life, an elixir of eternal youth. While science is far from this development, we can still be pretty excited about the possibilities that technology can provide for us as we get older. Technology is probably the biggest area that's exploding for older adults. Many types of technology, including web-based innovations, are having a positive impact on aging. These run the gamut from apps for everything from helping people with dementia stay creative to medication tracking apps and even apps to assist with navigation on handheld devices, such as enabling higher contrast viewing and large button navigation features on other apps. One area of technological development is helping innovate care delivered to older patients: age-specialized healthcare settings. This will in part encompass rethinking how healthcare services are organized and delivered, with geriatric surgical centers and emergency rooms already in place. Staff in such settings undergo specialized training, and the environment, instruments, tests performed, and interventions used are all designed specifically with older adults in mind, to translate what is known about best standards of geriatric care into practice. For example, this is a very high-tech emergency room in New York City at Mount Sinai. It has a big skylight. It has pressure-sensitive floors so that if older people fall in the emergency room, they won't break any bones. Usually, emergency rooms are very loud places. This emergency room is really quiet. You notice it's a lot less hectic. It's not like ER with George Clooney running around and blood and guts everywhere. That's not conducive to people getting better care. It's quiet and it's only for older people. Rates of readmission are low, and the success rates of procedures done in that environment are high. So there are economic and health benefits there, certainly. The Netherlands has the most cutting-edge nursing home facilities, but that is not their greatest innovation. They have developed a whole village designed for people with dementia. It's like a gated community, and the whole thing is designed for older people with cognitive impairments. It has large signage, easier to follow streets, very recognizable buildings. It also harks back to an earlier time period, so older people feel more familiar in that setting. In such a village, people can have pets, they can have independence, they can go about their daily life without being constrained. In most nursing homes, people are very constrained in what they can do and where they can go. Again, this is greatly freeing. It actually helps people stay engaged. It helps people stay independent for longer, even if they have dementia.